What's up, everybody? Crimson Raven here, and it is time for another Ziggurat video. This one's going to be a normal run. We're going to try to unlock hard mode with a couple of other characters that we haven't done yet. So, Leto's done. We have Loki. That would be a possibility. Agnes. Jules. I haven't unlocked it with Jules. Okay. Ozuna. Corvus. Algarab. Menzi. Let's do it with Menzi. I haven't played with Menzi for a long time. So, alright. 190th challenge of the Ziggurat. I might have played a little bit too much of this game. Okay, what do we got? First, Staff of Atlantis. I'm happy. Okay. So, the thing with Menzi, because we've never played with him on this channel here, I'm pretty sure. Menzi has a war cry and is vigilant, so we recover health and mana at the beginning of each battle. But mana gems and potions are not as effective as with every other character. He's got a shotgun-y, low fire rate kind of wand that does a decent amount of damage. Running away. Carrots. I don't really have a good weapon to clear out carrots. Well, the staff does one-shot them, so... Sure. There's one carrot left. It's over there. Come on. Can't damage it from here. There we go. Any secret rooms? Didn't take the time to check while I was fighting. None here. And one here. Good thing I checked. Obliterator. Better attack rate for a lower mana pool. I guess that's fine, because I'm recovering. But the mana recovery from Vigilant is percentage-based. It's not fixed. It still kind of screws me. I'm going to go for Telekinetic, because I don't want to weaken my other weapons. Go. It didn't drop that many health potions, unlike what the room bonus said. Don't have enough mana to be able to pay the price of the gods. Max health decreased. Well, fuck you, game. I might as well. Increase protection against enemy attack. So that's basically thick skin. Okay. Less health, but thick skin. And I'm recovering health at the beginning of every battle, even though it's percentage based, so now I'm recovering less. Don't see any secrets here. Let's go up. Treasure room. One green mana. Now that's a bit trollish. Is just gotta be methodical. I just gotta make sure I don't waste my mana. Attack rate seriously decreased against flying skulls? Good thing my wand is a freaking shotgun. Alright, level up. What do we got? I will go for Ignore Wounds. Because Menzi's not the toughest of characters. He's tough in the fact that he recovers health at the beginning of each battle, but otherwise, he's not very tanky. He can take a lot of damage, and he's not that fast, so he can't dodge it all that well either. Staff of Atlantis is doing work. Good God, I love this weapon. Okay. No secrets here. Anything at the end of the room? Nope. Let's just go that way then. That is King Blob. That is most definitely King Blob. So, down. Gotta go down. Key room, and there's one more door. Okay. Okay, my phone just unplugged itself, it seems. Carrots. I hate carrots. God fucking damn it. Carrots. Nope. Please die. Well, that was annoying. Okay, that one also leads to the boss room. Nothing here. Nothing here. Nothing here. Well, I guess it's time for the boss fight. With no green mana whatsoever. I'm gonna recover some. Not a lot. Well, not a lot. Maybe half. Something like that. Yeah, about half. Oh, green mana there. Got it. Ah, holy, drop this orange mana. Come on, drop me some green. Give me the green. Yes, green. Gotcha. Oh. There we go. Gotcha. And that is back to about half health. Back to a decent level of mana as well. I'm going to go and increase my staff mana pool because the Staff of Atlantis is incredible. And if I still recover 50% of it at the beginning of every fight, that's going to be a lot of bullets. So, floor one, done. Floor one, done. We made it okay. We made it pretty good. And we have a spell. The Hellish Amber. Okay, so fire shotgun. Basically. It's not a bad weapon by any means. Definitely not my favorite, but it's a decent one. Oh, wet floor. I hate wet floor. Especially with freaking invisible enemies. Be going too fast because okay, slow and methodical. There we go. No. Finally, holy crap, that was annoying. I hate wet floor rooms. You lose so much of your mobility, you just can't. No, that's not a door. Looks like it could have been, but it's not a door. Let's go that way. This way. Yeah, so it's not 50%, it's about like 30? Yeah. Come on, open up. There you go. I had forgotten how much damage this spell does. More mana for my staff. I'm happy. Open up. Three-shotting a plant. Holy crap. And there we go. So, next room. That's the biggest... That is the biggest advantage with Menzi, is at the beginning of every fight, at least you have some mana. That was a little stupid of me. Okay. That is a door. Recover some mana when hit. Sure. Not the best, because I don't have that much HP, but... if I am to get hit, I might as well... try to take some advantage of it. Efficiency. Yes. Whirlwind of Uthar. Nope. Keeping the shotgun. Whirlwind is good, but... Whirlwind is good, but I think I'm gonna still keep the shotgun. Because I'm not used to playing with the shotgun. And the Whirlwind is completely useless against flying enemies. of which there has been a fair amount so far. Shrine. Okay. Increased attack rate. Sure. Alright. Not gonna do that. Enemy speed decreased. Ah, now we're talking. I might come back if I have enough health after the next fight. What do we got? Teeny tiny room. More carrots. I'm liking this. I am liking this spell a lot. 50, so I'm exactly back to the HP I was at when I entered the room. Okay. Let's go explore some more. Oh, at least this room is not wet floor anymore. Once the fight is over, at least. Okay, let's go this way. That's the boss room, and that is Queen Amanda. Okay. Key. Might as well. Okay, no secrets anywhere. And that way? Go for bookworm. I'm getting 3 perks per level up now. So happy. Okay. What do we got? Scavenger room. Okay, run. In scavenge rooms, you have to apply the 5Ds of dodgeball. Okay. I got enough crystals. Time to start killing stuff. That was nice. Okay, so let's do the boss fight, and if I have if I'm close enough to full health after the boss fight, I will go back to the shrine and sacrifice some health. Queen Amanda. Alright, let's start this. Forgotten soul. And she's dead.
Ooh.
More champions, but more loot. More treasure room. But treasure rooms sometimes are bad. That is consistently more loot, but it'll make the fight a lot harder. So I'm gonna hope... Okay, I'm not gonna be sacrificing health just because of that. Time for floor 3. Archangel's Embrace. Nope, you know what? No, I'm keeping the shotgun. Even though the Embrace is a homing weapon. Actually, no, it's not a homing weapon. It's not a homing weapon, but I don't like the trajectory the bullets take and the fact that you can damage yourself with them. Okay, time distortion. That was nice and effective, although a bit sloppy, I have to admit. I'll go back up. Doppelganger shamans? Are you kidding me? Thank God for that damage. Holy crap. I can take a grand total of 4 shots with my wand. And treasure room. And that is... the Tiger Amulet. Double damage while it is active. Very, very useful to focus down bosses, actually. So I like this. I like this a lot. Let's go that way. Oh man, that is one of the hardest decisions I could have. Because mana regen is huge, but so is bloodlust. That one, I don't even have an alchemy weapon, so it's kind of useless right now. But these two... I have to go with survival. I have to go with bloodlust. As annoying as it might be for me. Alright, alright. What do we got? We got nothing here. Okay, that's just next door then. Shrine. Don't have the mana to pay for the shrine. I do have the health. I want to try it. Now I have Bloodlust. I have it a little bit. Twice the experience in my next combat. Ooh. Should I go for the boss? Because I'd get double experience from the boss. I don't know where the boss room is. If I knew, I probably would have gone straight for it. So I'm gonna check out the doors. That is the boss. I don't have the portal key yet. I gotta find the portal key. Let's hope that the portal key is either here or here. And if it's there, I'm taking the key and doing the boss right away. Even though I'm half health. Key. Yes. Did I find a... I didn't find a single secret room yet. I'll have to pay attention. Because I inspected every room so far, I think. Except maybe for this one. Nothing there. I didn't inspect the shrine either. Nothing there. Okay. Boss time! And it's... Percival! Okay. Percival the Royal Knight. Focus him down real quick. There you go. And now I get double XP for killing the boss. Yup. I like it. And now I'm gonna go over there and then down. And go inspect that last room I haven't checked yet. Another juggernaut room? Really? Come on, open up. There we go. Doppelganger again? Holy crap, okay. Magic missile. There we go. And while they're all nicely bundled up. Bloodlust is saving my ass right now. I'm so glad. I am so happy I took Bloodlust over Mana Regen. Because I already have some form of Mana Regen in Minzy's starting skills. Like, his starting perk is some form of Mana Regen, so... Obelisks. Gotcha. There you go. Don't be wasting your ammo. These two bigger ones with the blue buff earlier were very annoying. I was able to at least alternate shots between them just to force them to keep moving. Is that? Nope. I'm gonna have to keep an eye out for secret rooms, but usually there's not that many that can connect from this one, except maybe at this end. But there isn't. Okay. Did I? Yeah, I still haven't found the secret room on this floor. Okay. Storm Beast. Freeze the Storm Beast and kill the Storm Beast. There you go. The Atlantic Staff is a very, very, very good weapon here. I could go Bloodlust 2, or I could go Mana Regen for my staff. I'm gonna go Bloodlust 2. I need as tough as I can get. I'm probably gonna get mana regen over Bloodlust 3. But for Bloodlust 2, what it gives me is good enough. The difference is significant enough that I'm gonna take it before. Okay. We're on a high wall here. No secret doors. Nothing here. Time to go. Oh, salamanders. I might as well just tank it. Okay. Freeze. There you go. More? Let's just thin out the crowd a bit. Go, run around. That was invisible and a bit annoying. Okay, so that was a very, very big room. Anything here? Not that I can see. So it's a big ass dead end of a room. Yep, pretty much. And since the boss is already down, it's time for floor 4. Just gonna sprint it. So, left here. Ooh, books. Okay. And down to floor 4. So guys, because of how things usually work for me, for these normal runs, if they go beyond floor 3, that means I'm going to be making 2 videos. So, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in part 2.